And then while you guys are looking over, we're going to have a sort of request night. Okay? We're going to use tonight as sort of a worship service. Let me ask you a question. Can you passively worship? No, you have to be active to worship, don't you? So tonight, we're going to ask you guys to participate. If you know the songs, sing those. Okay? If you are especially brave, come on up. If there's a song that you really like and you want to give it a shot, come on up and sing with us. Okay? And as you're looking through the songs, if there's a song that means something special to you as you grew up or something real recently that's touched your heart, as you request it, yeah, stand up and give a little testimony. Say why the song means something special to you. Or if there's just something that's happened recently that you want to share God's goodness or what He's doing in your life, or maybe you need someone to pray for you, we'd be glad to do that for you tonight. Tonight, we're all going to be involved. We're just going to, we've all come here for one reason, and that's to praise Jesus. So let's all actively be involved in praising the Lord tonight. Okay, and we're going to start that activity right now. If everybody will get a hymnal and turn to page 37.
Any of you nice people that are sitting in the sun, that you would like to move one pew to get out of the sun, might make it a little cooler on you. You're welcome to that. Any room?
Is somebody on page 37? Is that the majesty and glory of His name? Okay. We're going to start by all of us singing that song. To set us up for a spirit of worship.
That he would sing as a soul, so we can remember it way the second verse of this song.
They call
pick up the cards and get ready for the drawing. Would you join us and singing We Are So Blessed?
Thank you.
Beach, and we grew up in church. It was my Uncle Monty who was the song leader, and my Aunt Betty who played the piano, and they had a quartet, and my dad sang bass, and another really close, which you know, as a kid, everybody's your aunt and uncle when you're in a close-knit family church like that, was Eva Denton. And that's one of the songs that they let me break in with the B quartet, get to sing with them. It was happening there, and later on tonight, I'm sure we had Feeling Fine, but that was another one that they let me break in and sing with them. That was always a special time. And we heard this part of the White House.
Waiting on you, bud.
Oh,
started out with a niece of mine that was just a really Nancy Miller Campbell. She could really play the piano. And then we worked with Everett Evans. And I remember one Everett's famous. He traveled with a bus. Everett's an Evans now. Everett worked with us for about 6 months, and I remember in the men's room at the Assembly of God Church up in Rancho Cucamonga, he put together this tag and started this working on that lighthouse. And, that's my memory of the song.
Maybe it's home to you. We'll go for a ring, we'll go for a ring, turn a distance up.
didn't finish out with my story. Of all the different piano players that we've had, and we've been told that's to work with some of the best ones, and Helen is magnificent.
Into the water of God.
What does he know of you?
He was old as well.
That song is my daughter's favorite song. Megan, if you know Megan, she's 7 and she's full of everything. She's here, there, everywhere. Tonight she spent the night at a friend's. But that's her favorite song. Anytime we ask for a special request, step into the water. One Sunday morning, when I get the kids up, there's always music time. And they were sneaking in a little bit later that day. And I turned on the stereo. I had a real quartet singing it, actually. It was the cathedral singing. I discovered the water came in. And I had it up pretty loud, so I could get their money up. And they started off stepping into, and then I hear coming out of her bedroom, and she's still in her bed.
On a hill far away,
Here's the dad.
Sixty-six just a few days ago.
It's okay, you look fantastic.
We have done a lot of singing in restaurants. And we go to restaurants and sing. And me personally, restaurants are hard for me. We always wonder what we can bring. But we go there and sing, and I prefer to sing the fast songs. But invariably, when we go sing somewhere like that, they want to hear the old ones. And one of the places we went, we sang in their community room. And we were dining, or even there was somebody coming and said, "Well, you can sing to this person who can't get out of bed." And what did they want to hear? The old Roy Harris. And we must have went to four or five different rooms and sang the old Roy Harris. It's the old hymns. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll use that one.
Okay.
Hey.
Crimson River?
Crimson River. I was hoping someone picked that one. That one was my mom's favorite.
Thank you. Jesus up in Canaan right now.
You could stay in heaven when you win.
read your Bible, it's a great morning for you. Well, it's a great, great moment, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the golden avenue. There are mansions on the right, and you feel at every sight, and the saints will always smile and say, how do you do?
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
is another one that Everett had an influence on.
He was born in a manger, and his life was meant to be taken away upon the cruel tree. He would be sin's atonement for sinners as I and
I'm
to the ocean's wide, wide fall.
You may go home now.
Thank you, Chip.